You look at your bank account and it doesn't seem as plump as you would like it to be. So how do we change that? This video, we're talking about how to change your mindset from one of lack and scarcity into one into abundance and opportunity, something that we believe is a human right, but it's just not a skill that a lot of us have been taught how to develop. Now, if you think that any of this stuff is just hippie, doesn't make sense, it's not real, I invite you to look at your own relationship with money and ask yourself, what is your relationship with money? And I dare say that most of the time, you're gonna find that what your beliefs are around money or what your financial situation looks like is very similar to that of your parents or whoever raised you. So there are some imprints there and we've got to tackle that, and healing your relationship with money is actually a real thing. So if you just hit this like button, we'll get straight into it. Also, just a really quick note, I did try to film this video not long ago, but we had some sound issues. So we revamped the video, made it a little bit better. So let's get into it. Number one, start talking about money. This is a taboo topic. So many people are afraid to talk about it, but the worst part is that they front that they don't have any issues with money. And so they sit in the background having dreadful conversations with their loved ones, with their family, internal battles with themselves, and yet on the outside, they try to pretend like they have it all together. Note that this isn't a skill that is taught to anybody. So most people really struggle with this. You need to start talking with your closest friends about this. What struggles they're going through? Is there anything that you can bounce off or learn together about finances? You need to make this a topic that you're okay to talk about, your struggles and your successes, because as long as it's taboo, you're staying in your own head with all the problems and challenges that you have. And the beautiful thing we have as creatures, human creatures, is that we discuss and we learn through this act. So be brave enough to form a circle of people that you really trust, that you'll be openly speaking to about finances, and you can confide your successes and your downfalls with. Number two, realize that money itself is meaningless. To have that beautiful car, that house that we all dream of, and yet we don't have it, so therefore it's money's fault. Poor money. Let me present to you an example. There's a carpenter and he has a box of nails. Those box of nails, they're not negative or positive. They're kind of meaningless on their own. The nails themselves are not a source of any woes or any negative emotions at all. They are just nails. However, the excitement for the carpenter lies with what he's able to build using the nails. And if the nails don't arrange themselves correctly, it means that the carpenter wasn't using the nails properly. It is not the nail's fault. It is the carpenter's fault. And this could be true for your own situation, because money itself is a tool. That is all it is. It is not responsible for your happiness. It should not be responsible for your happiness, but so many people think that if they can't buy something that they really want, it's money's fault. Money did that, so therefore I will hate on money and be angry at the fact that money even exists and we shouldn't have it and all the other emotions that come with it. But when we get a lot of money, then we start spending it and buying all these things, and all of a sudden you have so much joy and happiness. Once you release that and realize that money itself is just a tool of trade, it is quite empowering, actually. And then you put the full responsibility on yourself, understanding that this is a skill set. And again, you've never been taught this, so it's time for you to start investing energy into learning how this tool, money, works. Now, I will clarify that lots of people have been born into different situations, and holy crap, sometimes it's so hard for people. I get it. Not everyone has an equal footing when they started with money. They might have seen extreme fighting in their household, extreme trauma around finances in their household or with their family or whatever might have happened along the line. This is real. Not being able to pay any medical bills or just bills in general, not being able to send your children to school, wherever you want to go, this is crippling. So there is an understanding that this sucks, but it doesn't have to be your reality moving forward. Give money away. I know what you're thinking. Panic mode. What the hell is this woman talking about? Abort, abort. I don't even have enough money to pay my bills. Why on earth would I give money away? You've probably heard some sort of organizations, oftentimes religious organizations, saying that you should be giving money away. Christian organizations oftentimes talk about giving 10% of your income away. Pillars of Islam talk about giving away 2.5% of your possessions as part of zakat. And some people think that if these organizations say give that money away, you have to give it exactly to those sources. And that's not really true. It's not about giving to one specific organization or a group. It's more about the feeling that you get whenever you engage in this sort of a practice. Because once you start freely allowing money to circulate and not hanging on to it so tightly, you're showing the universe that you have a feeling of abundance. Someone that doesn't have abundance doesn't give away extra money. And so you have to start asking yourself, what is it that gives you spiritual nourishment whenever you're giving away money? What makes you feel good? And I can't tell you what that feels like for yourself. I don't know what makes you feel good. Maybe it's paying your grandma's bill every single month to ensure that she has electricity affordably. Or if there's an animal shelter down the road that you want to support and help out with, just supporting them a little bit is probably going to make you feel so good about about yourself. Unfortunately, the majority of people that engage in the act of giving often have quite negative emotions tied to it. There's charities that always guilt you into feeling bad for having money, and therefore you should give because otherwise you're a bad person. And so you give the money away and you start feeling pretty dreadful. Like, it doesn't make you feel better. And so that whole exercise isn't really working. It's not uplifting you the way it should be, because the act of giving away should be there to reinforce positive emotions around finances and the good that this tool is able to do. The more that you're able to create good feelings around money, especially when you're giving it away, that's when you're starting to heal the relationship with finances. So find organizations that make you feel good whenever you give to them. For Leon and myself, we give away 10% of our income. For you, it could be 1%. It could be 5 cents, 50 cents, whatever you can do in a month, but it's the feeling associated with when you are giving the money away that you're seeking. And in time, maybe you'll be able to give away just a little bit more once you start making more and more money. Start being mindful with your money. Statistically speaking, 46% of Americans are going to struggle coming up with $400 in case of an emergency. 60 to 70% of those Americans are going to face an emergency situation within 6 to 12 months. So if you're not prepared for these scenarios, it means you're really going to react badly around money, and you're going to have the story that money is evil and you're going to hate it, and it's going to be very traumatic for you to even discuss this or try to manage it. So before you get into a situation where you're faced with this emergency, you need to prepare yourself and be very mindful with how you treat money and how you organize your finances. Are you that kind of person that just gets the money and then you throw it away all through consumerism, or just giving it away, or you don't even know where it goes throughout the month? Do you know where your income's coming from and what your expenses are every single month? Do you know this information, or are you just going blind throughout your life when it comes to finances? If you are that kind of person, it's time to start saving properly. Now, we haven't done a dedicated video on savings. If you want me to make that video, please drop it down below and let us know if this is something you're interested, because this is the first pillar of learning how to manage money, because those who manage their money wisely get more money to manage. Start a gratitude journal. Oprah says this is one of the most important tools that she does in her life, and it's worked for her, obviously. When you are able to focus on what you do have, you'll get more of that in your life. When you focus on things that are always going bad, you're gonna get more of that. It's how your brain is going to wire out those opportunities because you're focusing on them. Most humans are negatively wired, and their brain always seeks the negative things that happen in their life. So you get more of that. And a lot of people aren't very grateful. Look at your circle of friends. How many of them are like, wow, life is amazing, this is great? A lot of them are probably a little bit of negative Nancy's. So if you're surrounded by that energy and you yourself are that kind of a person, it's time to change that, because you really want to be grateful for what you do have. By being very aware of the beauty in your life, you start seeking out more of that, because your brain is showing you more of those opportunities. You know for yourself, the people that for some reason have that beautiful energy, that really vibrant and joyful energy, everything always seems to go well for them. So why wouldn't you want to put yourself in that state? And that is by putting pen to paper every single day. Make it a habit every single day. Write 10, 15, 20 pieces of gratitude. Even if it's really difficult, write, I'm breathing. I had something to eat today. If it's that small, that's fine, but it's wiring your brain to start looking out for the good in your life. However many points you need to put on your gratitude journal in order to start feeling that, I don't know, this beauty that comes from inside that is just so overwhelming and you just feel so light. That's where you want to get to. So keep writing every single day. Lastly, surround yourself with beauty. I'm not going to talk about this a lot. We had another video that did really well that we just released. Watch that one. It's awesome. But do you think a wealthy or someone that thinks abundantly and sees the beauty of the world, do you think they'd want to surround themselves by things that bring them down? Low vibrations in their environment that just makes them feel crappy. So you go into a room and you just feel so ugh. Do you feel like that's going to create abundance within you? Probably not. So by doing simple, small things that are going to make you feel really good about yourself, because your environment absolutely dictates the insides as well. So if your environment makes you feel a certain way, you're going to project a really great existence for yourself, and you're going to attract better opportunities. Now, it doesn't have to be expensive. Little flowers that you pick around you from around the gardens, secondhand stores. My office is filled with secondhand store, amazing things that I've sourced that I love. I have dried flowers everywhere. Small, simple things to make you feel abundant, because you are a wealthy, beautiful person. If it's not physically in manifestation right now, it's in the making. So act like it. All right, well, that's it. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure you like and also comment. It helps us immensely in getting the message of finance and freedom out to the world. Also, we have an amazing newsletter that people love. Like, they actually love it. It's kind of crazy. So if you want to find out what the buzz is all about, go to the link in the bio. And finally, for a limited time, we have 20% off our membership if you use the code YouTube at checkout. So if you want to find out more about this little membership world that we've created, all about finance and freedom, global citizenships, all this epic stuff to just make you as free as possible, there's a link in the bio for that. And I will see you in the next one.